Hello and welcome to another stream. My name is Ray and it is Learning Korean with Ray. Day 61. Yeah, welcome to the viewers that are already on the stream. Yesterday we did the reviewing, I think, and we learned the first 8 or 10 vocabulary of lesson 7 in the second half of yesterday. And today we'll just continue. A bit repeating of the words we learned yesterday, a bit learning new words from lesson 7. So just standard, we go through the lesson 7 vocabulary. So let's start right away. Here we have memorize, and we go into this course and we check lesson 7. And here you can see there are a total of 42 words and we have learned 23%, which is 10 words. Okay. So here are the 10 words we learned yesterday and there are some more to learn. Okay, so let's start with the review. Okay, teacher profession. So it, I think there's Kyo. Oh, 1 second. Okay, Kyo. Kyo-sa, I think. Kyo-sa.
Kyo-sa.
You know, Kyo is education and sa is person, basically. Okay, here we have eyebrow. We have nun for eye. And then we have a weird one. It was like sam, sap, sop.
Nunsop.
Yeah. Nunsop. Okay, nunsop. Okay, then we have wall. Wall, the mem was like blocks, but it was not really blocks, it was byok. 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 Okay, very good. Clothes. That was just like this person. So here we have the head of the person. Then we have the hands. You don't see it, but my camera is too narrow here. And then we have this one. Is it not? Is it? Oh, we are missing the neck. So maybe, yeah, like this. You see, there's neck. Then there are the two arms, and now we add the body leading into the legs, like this. And that is that Ot. Letter. Ot. Okay, hair is like fingers. Fingers is like hand and then karak. And here we have head and then karak. So we need the word for head, which is body or mori. And now we need the word, this is added thing, karak, 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 karak. Is it not correct? Wait, it's body.
Body karak.
Body karak. Okay, dinner, evening. Evening was a chore, and then chore. I don't remember. I need to look. Choriom. I will give a maybe. Jojo, no. Jogan. No. Joron. No. Josa, no. Oh, this is it. John Yok. Okay, this time it's not the hair on the head, it's the hair on other parts of the body, which is also called fur for animals. And that is toll. Toll.
Toll.
Toll. Classrooms is pan.
Pan.
Pan. Oh, work location. That was a bit harder to remember. I think Jang was the second syllable. It's like Jojang. Jajang.
직장.
직장. Okay, lunch, noonish. Okay, so since there's this noonish in there, it's basically a time. So that means we need Shigan. And there's something in front of this. And I know it. It's like the first starts with this and the second starts with this one. Jomshim? Jomshim?
점심시간.
Nice. Wow, all correct. All correct. And I didn't even have to like think that long. Just evening, I had to go through the options, but apart from that, was pretty nice. Okay, what do we have here? One for review. Okay, let's do it. To listen. Dil Buddha? No. Is there a harder, maybe? Dil Buddha? No. Somehow I have this bow in my head. Damn, I don't know it anymore. Ah, there's the bow. Hada. Chihada? No. I'm a bit confused. I'm staying with this one, to be honest. Tilbohada. Hi, nice, great, good. Him? Him is not an option here. To listen is the word we want to translate. And I think I already had the situation that a viewer in my chat was saying, yeah, but usually you use this word, but and so on. I'm just trying to think about the one that I've learned. And it must be from those action. I know Dutta, I know this one. But that was to hear. That was introduced to me as to hear. And this one, is another one, and it's kind of similar. It starts with this one. That's what I know for sure. Derrida. Yeah, but this is not an option here. Ah, Derrida? Derrida? No. Derrida is not an option. It must be from these options here, you know? I want to say Tilboda. Tilbohada? I will just click it, and I need too long anyway, so let's see. Okay, it's wrong.
들어보다.
들어 ah. 보다 was correct.
들어보다.
But all is in it here as well. Okay, 들어보다. Okay, I will remember it from now on. I will remember. 들어보다. Teroboda. Teroboda. Teroboda.
Teroboda.
Okay, we have difficult words, which is exactly the same. Okay, Okay, I think that should be enough, and I will go for, should we do listening skills? Okay, let's do a quick listening skills session. 50 words. 50 words to review. Let's go.
선생님.
선생님, teacher. 선생님.
선생님. Canada.
Canada, Canada.
Canada. 학교.
학교, school.
학교. 남자.
남자, man. 남자.
남자. 개.
개. Dog.
개.
개.
호텔.
호텔. Wow. Is it ho or ho? Hotel. I think like this. Hotel. Ah, it's really ho.
Hotel.
Hotel. Okay.
이름.
이름. Name.
이름.
네.
네. Yes.
네.
네.
아니.
아니. No.
아니. 새롭다.
새롭다. To be new. Right? 새롭다. Yeah, to be new. 새롭다. 예, it's like quiz. It helps to learn, you know? You need to repeat. 새롭다.
새롭다.
Nice. If you 배우다. Enter it correctly, it will be green. And there are these options here, but I'm not looking at them. I try to do it without this option. I really don't look at them. I just write it here on my keyboard, and I don't look at this option before. Only if I don't know it, then I will look at the options. But before that, I will not look. Okay, so...
배우다.
배우다. To learn or to think. To learn, I think. 배우다. 배우다.
배우다.
아름답다.
아름답다. To be beautiful. 아름. Dabda.
아름답다.
의사.
I learned all the this all the vocabulary, like verbs, nouns, adjectives, verbs, yeah, everything.
의사.
의사, for example, doctor. See, that's a noun. See, I'm learning everything.
의사.
It's always
통항.
All the vocabulary that you use about this one. I'm using this one website, howtostudykorean.com, and I can show you. It's basically this website, and here are different like grammar lessons, okay? And I finished like lesson 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and now I do lesson 7 next, okay? This is the next lesson. And whenever you learn a lesson here, you, for example, you have some explanations, some grammar, and then there are some words that get used. But before I can do this lesson, I need to understand the vocabulary. There's always like 50 words of vocabulary for this lesson. So this is the vocabulary you see here, like eyebrow, teacher, class of students in school, location of work, wall. All these words are used in this lesson, or yeah, sometimes they are not, but these are all the words that I learn right now. These are all the words, like all the words here. So here you have nouns, then you have some verbs, and they have some adjectives. And I learn all of these, adverbs as well. And then I will do this grammar lesson. That's always the plan. So now I will keep learning those verbs here, those words. So, and I use this website to learn those words here, that vocabulary. Okay, so it's really mixed.
공항.
공항. 공항 is airport. 공항.
공항.
These are all words from previous lessons as well. So lessons 1 to 6. I learned like, I don't know, maybe 300 words, 400 words. I'm not sure. 공항. 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 Is it not correct? See, I have some different tools here. Look at this. So I can put the word here. Kung. Maybe I should make it a bit like this. Kunghang. Kunghang. And now this website gives me YouTube videos where this word is used.
그래서 이런 식으로 공항철도를 타고 출근하면서
아, that's a bit fast, so we can reduce the speed.
그러다가 몇 달 동안 그래서 이런 식으로 공항철도를 타고 출근하면서
still very quick in this video, so we go to the next video. Ah, that's a lot of text. Let's go to the next. Here, this one, let's see.
히더로 공항 출구를 못 찾아서 세 바퀴를 돌았어. 히더로 공항 출구를 못 찾아서 세 바퀴를 돌았어. 히더로 공항 출구를 못 찾아서 세...
Very fast, very fast.
강사로 제가 데리고 있다가 최근에 또 다른 공방에 독립을 해서 지금 공방 운영을 하고 있고.
That's super fast. Holy shit.
대한항공이 활주로에 쌓인 눈더미 때문에 여객기가 손상됐다며 한국 공항공사에 50억 원의 배상 대한항공이 활주로에 쌓인 눈더미 때문에 여객기가 손상됐다며 한국 공항공사에 때문에 여객기가 손상됐다며 한국 공항공사에 50억 원 때문에 여객기가 손상됐다며 한국 공항공사에 50억 원의
Yeah, I want to find something where the word is in the beginning. Ah, here. This is perfect. Let's see.
공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 PP 카드를 또 줬었어. 그러면 공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 그러면 공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 그러면 공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 그러면 공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 P.
Yeah, it's hard. Let's do a bit slower.
그러면은 공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 PAP 그러면은 공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 공항 라운지를 쓸 수 있는 PAP.
Yeah, I think 공항 is pretty close, right? 공항. 공항. Should be close enough. So let's go back to learning. 공항. Okay, so what do we have here now? Mun, that's very low volume. Mun is a door. Mun. Mun.
Kil.
Kil is a street.
Kil.
Kil.
An.
An. Inside.
An. Doshi.
Doshi. Doshi. City.
Doshi. Pisada.
Pisada. To be expensive. Pisada. Pisada.
Pisada. Nun.
Nun. Eye.
Nun. Tari.
Tari. Leg.
Tari. 냉장고.
No, no. I'm German. I have no connections to anything from Asia. I'm just learning for myself.
냉장고.
냉장고, refrigerator. 냉장고, 냉장고. 냉장고. 냉 냉장고. 장고.
냉장고.
냉장고.
버스.
버스. 버스. Pause.
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 아침 식사.
I you know a lot of basic words. Well, I know a lot of basic words because I'm learning them. I'm studying, like I'm doing this project. You can see in the title on this Twitch stream here, you will see. Day 61. So I have already done 60 days of learning. Like 60 days I learned 1 hour every day. And so that's where I learned all these words. I didn't know a single word before. I just learned these words. Okay. Yes. I will do 1 year. Easy, 365 days.
Achim shiksa.
Achim shiksa, breakfast. Achim shik shiksa.
Achim shiksa.
Breakfast.
Kabang.
Kabang, backpack.
Kabang. 저,
저, I, formal.
저, 있다.
있다, to have or to be in a location. 있다.
있다. 배.
배, stomach or pier. Or boat.
배. 중국.
China. 중, 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 중국. 중, 중, wait. 중,
중국.
중국.
연습하다.
연습하다. To practice, I think. Yeah, practice.
연습하다. 집.
Cheap house.
집. 은행.
은행 bank.
은행. 방.
방. Room.
방. 여기.
여기, here. 여기
여기 고양이
고양이 cat 고 양이
고양이 안
Sometimes I have some Korean viewers. Sometimes I don't. So sometimes they are coming, but sometimes I have like almost no viewers. It's fine. I'm just doing this for myself. Sometimes I have like 5, 6, 7 viewers, but sometimes I only have 1 or 2. That's how it goes.
An.
An.
An. 만나다.
만나다, to meet. 만나다.
만나다. 학생.
학생, student.
학생. 그.
그. That from a previous sentence.
그.
그. 그.
미국.
미국, USA.
미국. 잡지.
I think you learn more difficult. What do you mean? I should learn more difficult words or I could learn easier? What do you mean?
잡지.
잡지 magazine.
잡지. 하지만.
Advanced words. Yeah, I will do that. Hello, new viewer. I don't know how to pronounce your name, but yes, this is memorized. I will learn some new words. This is just repeating. To really remember the words, you have to repeat very often. So these words I learned already in the previous weeks. So I repeated them already. I have them in my head, most of them. And I will learn new words after this here. You see this orange bar here? This orange bar, it's almost at the end. When this is at the end, I will learn new words, okay? That I don't know, that I have no idea.
하지만.
하지만 is but. 하지만. 하지만.
하지만. 일본.
You see, it's going a bit more to the right.
일본.
일본 is Japan. 일본.
일본 사람 사람
사람 is a person 사람
사람 나라
Oh, you're learning to Korean too. That's nice. How far are you? I don't have a Korean keyboard. My keyboard is completely the same. 1 second. I can show you something. Weird. 1 second, maybe here. Well, I can, like, I have normal keyboard. It's a German keyboard. But my webcam here is mirrored, you know, so it's hard to see. But I don't know why I can't change it right now. It's a bit weird. Can I change it here? No. It's weird. I can. No, I did not put stickers. I just learned it like that. I have this one. I show you. You see, I have this one. You see, I can see the layout here. So with this, I learned. I just looked at this, and to be honest, it was pretty quick. I learned it in in like 3 days or so. It was pretty easy, in my opinion. This is called on-screen keyboard. It's just with every Windows. It's I did not install a specific program. It was just installed with Windows itself, my operating system. On-screen keyboard is the name. You should have it. Like I can put it in the chat. On-screen keyboard. Oh wait, I need to switch to English. On-screen keyboard. Okay, there. I put the name in the chat, but it's included in your operating system if you're Windows. If you're using Windows 10, it's already included. And you can put it to any language, like any language that you can select in Windows. You have to like install like Korean language in Windows, but then you can use this. And see, I can switch between like now it's English keyboard. Yeah, okay, anyways, let me continue. Okay, see you. Nice, great, good. Thanks for tuning in.
나라.
나라, country.
나라. 한국.
한국, Korea. 한국.
한국.
Bye, 안녕. God. Cot thing.
Cot.
Copy.
Copy. Coffee. Copy.
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 여자.
여자. Woman. 여자.
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 나무.
나무 tree.
나무.
Okay, so we are finished with repeating. Now it's time for new words. Let's go for new words here. Okay. Chada, chada, right? Chada.
찾다
찾다 찾다
찾다
찾다 to search for to find 찾다 찾 찾다 okay
가르치다
oh to teach I was hoping this is like teacher but it's not that's bad okay 가르, 가르치, 가르치다, 가르치다.
가르치다.
가르치다. 치다.
가르치다.
가르치다. 가르. 가르치다. 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 Okay. Chatta. Chatta.
Chatta.
찾다 가르치다
가르치다
일하다
일하다 to work il is work and 일하다 is to work Wait, how can I call you? I just see Chinese letters or so. I'm not sure. No, that's not Chinese. I'm not sure what it is. But wait, what's your name on Twitch? Medi. Should I just Mediv? Is Mediv correct? Mediv? Or is it wrong? Mediv? Is Mediv correct? Or do I pronounce it bad? Mediv? Wow. From World of Warcraft, okay. Mediv. Okay. So where are you from and how long do you study Korean already? I'm from Turkey and I only learned Hangul and some basic vocab from songs. Okay, so you're at very beginning. Yeah, it's hard in the beginning. Yeah, pronunciation is difficult. But I really like that in the beginning you really have like one specific letter from Hangul you have for one sound. It's always the same in the beginning, you can like learn like that, but later on you will realize some letters sound differently depending on if they are in the beginning or in the end of a syllable. So for example, this is a syllable here, it's a jit, but this one at the bottom is usually an S, but in this case it's like a T. Jit. It's not jis. It's jit. Jitta. So, yeah, this is a bit difficult. But I have actually a good chart here. I can put it in the chat 1 second, but I will show it on stream as well. So I put it in the chat for later. But here you can see it. So this is like some website. And here you have like a chart. For example, let's look at this word we have here. So the first syllable ends in like an S, like S, S. And the next is da. So it's like a D in the beginning. So now let's use this information. So the bottom letter of the previous word is an S. Okay, this one. And the next letter, the first letter of the next syllable, is this one, okay? So we have this one followed by this one. So here you can just see, okay, it's pronounced like this. Okay, so it's like a D and then an even stronger D for the next syllable. So it's more like a D. You don't hear an S at all. It's more like a D. And sometimes that can be very weird. For example, if you have this one, this is a K, but if it's followed by an N, it's actually becoming like an NG. This is NG. So it's not a K at all. It's just NG and N instead of K and N. So some letters can sound or can be pronounced differently. This is just pronunciation. So they can be pronounced differently depending on if they are in the end of a syllable, so if they are at the like the bottom of a syllable, and then the next letter of the next syllable is a specific other letter, then it can sound a bit like weird. So that's always when you have like a consonant at the bottom of a syllable. That's not super common, but yeah, you will learn it. But you shouldn't care too much about in the beginning. So if you're still starting, you shouldn't care about that much. But later on, you can see it there. Whenever you think, wait, this, for example, this syllable is like jis. If I just use the individual letters, so it's like a J. The first one is J. Then this one is like an E. E, and this one is like an S. So I would say jizz, okay? But it's not jizz. You will realize it's jitta, jitta.
Jitta.
Jitta. There's no S in there. And if you think, hey, why is he pronouncing it without an S, but there's clearly an S in the end, then you can look at this chart and see why, okay? So, yeah, but in the beginning, you should not care too much about this, because these syllables with a consonant in the bottom are not super common, okay? So, usually the syllables end in a vowel. Yeah, Google Translation, sometimes it can be good, sometimes it can be bad. I don't know yet, but some people who are also a bit advanced in learning Korean, and also some Koreans, they told me I should just use the Korean Google, the Korean dictionary. And that's what you can find here. So this is Nava Korean Dictionary. Yes, Nava. So if you just like Google Nava Korean Dictionary, you will see, okay, you have this Nava connection, this dictionary, and you can go to Korean. You can change your language here to English, so you understand everything. And then you go to Korean. And then, for example, you enter the word here. So, for example, jitta that we just had. Then you have some sounds here.
Jitta.
Jitta. Jitta. And not jista. And this is mostly, like often, it is really Korean speaking it. And it's not like computer generated. It's really a Korean speaking it. So I can give you the link in the chat, so that's the one. So that's is probably the best website where you can check Korean pronunciation. Yeah, but yeah, don't get like overwhelmed by these pronunciation rules in the beginning. First, it's you need to understand like what the all the letters sound like by themselves, you know, when there's no special rule, when they are just normally, like for example this one da, then it's like this one is a D and the first one is a D and the second one is a R, so it's like da. It's very easy, and that's very good. That's what I love about Korean language. But yeah, sometimes you have these special rules that the bottom part, the bottom consonant, if there's a consonant at the bottom, it can be a bit weird sometimes, but you will learn it. It's not too hard. Okay, so jitta to build. Jitta, jitta, jitta. Some consonants also change sound if they're in the first syllable of the word. Yes, that's true. I'm not super sure when it's happening, but for example, let's say you have the word, wait 1 second. I will put it in the chat. Let's say you have the word bang, which is just a room. So this means room. It, you see there's like a B in the beginning, okay? A B. This thing with a stripe. The first letter there is like a B. So in this case, it sounds like a P because it's in the beginning. But if you have the same letter, for example, here in this thing, il bun, here it's a B. But if it's in the beginning, it's like a P. And the same is true for this, what you say there, this G or K. Especially, yeah, this is also often the case. And when it's in the beginning of a word, not only of a syllable, but of a whole word, So when there's like a space in front of it, it sounds like a K. And but if it's in the middle of a word, it sounds like a G. Yeah, that's true. A very, very good example of this is this word. Wait, let me try to make sure that I'm using the correct one. Kage, yeah, see this one, it's door, kage. You can see this romanization is a G, no, because you know this is a G, but since the first one is in the beginning of the word, it's like a K, but the second one is in the middle of a word, so it's like a G. So this one is kage, kage. It's not gage, and it's also not kake. It's kage. First one K, second one G. Kage. Kage. Yeah. Okay. Let's continue. To work. Ilhada. Kage. Yeah. Okay, to build. Jitta.
Jitta.
Jitta. Here, example. This is a ka, kare. So this one is a K again. Kare. Jitta. Jitta. Kare. Jitta. Kare. Jitta. To teach.
가르치다.
가르치다.
가지다.
가지다. Oh man, very many that sound similar. Would be hard to remember. 가지다. But this one looks easy. See, often you don't have consonant in the bottom of a syllable. It's mostly ending on the vowel. So then you don't have any super special rules. 가지다. To own. Okay. Kajida. 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 Okay.
잠그다.
잠. 잠. 그다. 잠. 그다. Jam kida. Kajida.
Kajida.
Jam kida.
Jam kida.
Gida. See, this was a mistake by myself. I said jam kida, but it's wrong because the k is in the beginning, in the middle of a word. So it's jam gida. Jam gida. And not kam, jam kuda. So that was a mistake from myself here. So yeah, if it's in the middle, it's a G, and if it's in the beginning, it's a K. Because this syllable that we just saw, this k, that is very often by itself, this one. It's very often by itself, so, and then it's always k. So I remembered this as k, but it's in the middle, it's k. Yeah, it means that. Okay, let's go. Here you have this. You have another special case. You have a J in the end. J in the end is pretty much always a D. So again, you can check it on this page. Like J in the end, you can see D, D, D. Yeah, here it's not a D, here it's an N. If there's an N in the next one, it's just like an N, this one. But in this case where I have it followed by DA, it's followed by DA, so it's followed by this one. J and D makes D and D. D and even double D, so like more tensed, more stressed. Yeah, but trust me, it's not that hard. You will learn it quickly, but you should not care about this, of course. I'm just showing it so that you see why I say, in this case, I say itta, itta, and not ijda or so. Ijda. That's not that doesn't
Itta.
exist. It's itta. It's pronounced like a D. Itta. Okay. Okay, chatta was to search.
찾다.
Chatta.
돕다.
Here, this is another one of the thing you mentioned. If the D is in the beginning of the word, it's like a T. And if it's in the middle, like here, it's a D. So this one is topta. Topta. Not dopta, but topta. Like a T in the beginning, but D here for this other one. Topta. 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 Yeah. Okay, to forget. Itta.
Itta.
Itta. Jam gyda. Jam gyda. Jam gyda. To lock.
잠그다.
Jam gyda. Itta to forget.
Itta.
To help. Topta. Topta.
돕다.
돕다. To search for chat, 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 I think, chatta.
찾다.
예, 찾다.
주다.
주다. Oh, I know this one already. I know this one. 주다. 주다. So that's easy for me. 짓다. To build. Chitta. Oh, there are so many that very similar, so it's it will be hard. Like to forget, to lock, to build. They all sound kinda similar. Chitta. Oh, I just realized, for example, this one. Chitta and this one, they are pronounced exactly the same, I think, because they have the first one has the J and the second one has the S at the end of the syllable, of the first syllable. So if you look at this, we can see J and S followed by da, followed by de. Is both the same. You see, J and S is both this one. So those two words sound exactly the same. Jitta. You might want to make mnemonics. It's hard for me. Mnemonics. I've never said that word before. Mnemonics. Okay. Yeah, I mean,
짓다.
you have some possibilities here on memorize, you know, and I think I can handle it with them. I don't think I need anything else outside of memorize. Kupta, topta, topta to help.
돕다.
topta. Ilhada to work.
일하다.
일하다.
맞다.
But here, see, this is what I mean. You have these things here at the bottom. Matta. It doesn't matter. Matta. Matta. My answer is the correct one. It matches. Match. Yeah, see, this is a. It matches, so it's correct. because this is like much, but it's pronounced matta. Yeah. Matta. Yeah, let's put this one. I used to do memorize for Japanese too, but then I stopped doing it because after a certain level, memorize becomes useless. What do you mean with a certain level? I just use memorize as a tool to learn vocabulary, not to learn anything else. The real learning happens on howtostudykorean.com. So, this website. Here's where I learn my stuff. Like, here I learn about pronunciation, for example, like honorifics, pronunciation. I have all these grammar texts here. I did all of this, how you conjugate all the verbs and yeah, all the words here to different tenses for different formalities or respect forms and so on. So this is what I use. This is the main learning part. And I just use for the vocabulary. There's always this vocabulary in the beginning of a lesson. Only for that I use memorize. The thing is, you can't make your own stuff easily, and there is no context for the the context comes with the lessons on howtostudykorean.com, because they are using the words that I learn here, they're using it in their lessons, most of them at least. But you're right, of course, context is helping to remember. But yeah, I think I get enough context for now. Yeah, here you can see here, I'm just using the vocabulary from howtostudykorean.com grammar lessons. So this is what I use. Yeah, I might switch in the future as well, but for now I think it's good. I use howtostudykorean.com for the grammar. I use memorize with the howtostudykorean.com units for the vocabulary, and I watch the howtostudykorean.com YouTube videos for like practice of the grammar stuff that I learned. So yes, I'm full howtostudykorean.com so far, but I'm using three different media types to learn it. It's completely free and it has all the stuff that you need. I can show you something. So you see I'm here now, okay? I'm learning the vocabulary of lesson 7, okay? If I go to vocabulary here, lesson 7, here you can see here, to search for, to work, to build. That's are the words that I just learned, right? So this is completely free and I'm at lesson 7, okay? Now don't be afraid, but I will show you something, okay? So this is unit 0, lesson 1, 2, 3, okay? Then we have unit 1. This starts again with lesson 1, okay? But now this is the first real lesson. It goes to 25, but that's only unit 1, okay? You see this? Lesson 150. And I need around, like 6 days for one lesson. Yeah. So, it takes some time, but that's always when you learn a language, you know? But after lesson 6, you can already build sentences. For example, let's see here. There's always like a little text here. You will learn the basic structure of Korean sentences and how to create sentences using the word to be. And then you will learn other ways to create sentences and so on. For example, here, sentence order, sentence word order. It's, you see, like it's subject, object, verb and so on. So I hamburger eat, and then you have all this text, and then you have some some this is the first lesson, remember, this is the first lesson, so there's not, you get, don't get overwhelmed by Korean letters here, but yeah, you learn that you need something called particles that you add to certain words to say it's a subject or it's an it's object. Yeah, it's subject object verb, but for example, let me see, is here for example, I speak Korean, you would say I Korean speak, you know, I Korean speak. Oh, it's the same in Turkish and Japanese. Yeah, then it should be easier for you. In Germany it's other way. In Germany it's like English, so I only know German and English because I'm German. So in this, yeah, this is the same, German and English, but Korean is different. So I Korean speak, but Korean has like this special thing that you have to still say what is the object, the subject of the sentence, and what is the object. So for example, you add this particle to say, okay, I is the subject of this sentence. So you say this nun, okay? So here, my mom will make pasta. My mom is the subject. So you add this thing after my mom. Do you always put I, you, he? Yeah, you sometimes can omit it. Yes, you can leave it away. Yeah, you don't need to use it often. For example, when you say I love you, you don't say I love you, you just say like basically love. Or yeah, to love. Yeah, sometimes you can leave out the things, yes. You mean these particles is pain in the ass? Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. You need to put them in every sentence, yes, but that's just how the language works. Ah, you mean the he, she, it. Yeah, I mean, sometimes you can get it from context, but sometimes you don't have the context and then you need it, you know? So yes, Korean is a very like context-based language. Like a lot of things you can get from context. For example, there's no plural or singular. For example, this sentence here, my mom, okay, I mean it's English, but if it would be Korean here, yeah, with my mom it makes no sense, but here, for example, I letter wrote, okay, this could also mean I wrote letters, so multiple letters, okay. So you don't have plural or singular. It's, you can have one or you can have many. Or also, there's no like difference between a letter, I wrote a letter, or I wrote the letter. There's no difference. You always get it from context. Yeah, so I do all this, like when I do a lesson like this, I learn the vocabulary in the beginning with Memrise. So here I learn the vocabulary, then I read all the lessons here, all these chapters, and then in the end you have some practice videos and you can click here. It goes to a YouTube video.
All right, let's practice some sentences. I'm going to prompt you with some English sentences from Unit 1, Lesson 1.
And you get some practice.
It's your job to translate these sentences into Korean. The first one that we'll start off with is, I am a student. When I do this, let's always use the informal na for...
Yeah, and also, you will not be able to form correct sentences in the first lesson because you learn some more things about conjugating verbs in lesson 5 and 6. So here you use the base form of the word of the verb, which is unconjugated. So here you have to put you have to translate the sentence, and it's like some practice. You say I student am, basically, or yeah, doesn't matter, you will see yourself. But these videos are pretty those videos are pretty nice. Yeah, here, for example, if you have to be, you just say I student. Just I student. Okay. Yeah, dictionary form. Yes, dictionary form. Yes. So here in the beginning, you use dictionary form if you have some verbs. Yeah, these are easy sentences because you always have this verb to be. So here, I am a student, or this is a car. This basically you don't need it. You can just omit it in Korean. You just leave it out basically. Anyways, the handwriting is a bit. You have to get used to that, but but so far I really like these videos as well. Okay, so I'm already at 6 minutes after 7. Usually I always do 1 hour from 6 to 7 CET. So I'm a bit behind on schedule because I have not finished this. Let me finish this to build. Jitta.
Jitta.
Jitta. To help. Topta.
Topta.
To give Chuda.
Chuda.
Chuda. To forget. Ooh, I forgot it. was it the other one? Was it this one? Chitta? No. Ah, to forget. Okay, so I always try to get it from my head without looking at these options, but now I will look at the options and then I can see it is. No. Bunda, no. Wait, what? Ah, itta. It's itta.
Itta.
Okay. To be correct, this was like I have this from this menotic, this mem. This was this meta, you know, meta. So it's like matta.
Matta.
Yeah, or match, yeah, if you pronounce the consonant in the end of the syllable like it would be pronounced in the beginning, then it's like matchta, yeah. Matchta, yeah. Okay, to teach. To teach was something like kare. There was this menotic with garage. Kare jida. I thought it was this kare jida. It's chida.
Kare chida.
Chida. Okay. Not Jida, but Chida. Chida, like a T in front of it. Okay, to work is Ilhada.
Ilhada.
Kajida is to own.
Kajida.
Kajida.
Karuchida.
Karuchida. Karuchida is. We just said that. To teach.
가르치다.
Yes. To teach. Mata, to be correct. So, this is a bit weird. Okay, it looks like there are two different ways to say to be correct. But this one is it.
Mata.
To own, possess. Kajida? Kajida?
Kajida.
Yeah. Yeah, of course. Like, Memrise has some weaknesses for sure, but yeah, I like it so far. Maybe I'll switch in the future. But you know, I showed you about this website, How to Study Korean. I just showed you. If you go to a lesson here, ah, wait, that was a YouTube video. So if you are at the lesson here, lesson one, for example, you have this different like chapters, and the first is always vocabulary. So you always learn some vocabulary that is used in this lesson. Okay, you have some vocabulary here, like around 40 to 50 words every lesson, and there's actually always the link to the Memrise course. So if you go to that, then you have this. So yeah, since they use Memrise, I thought, yeah, I will use Memrise as well. I actually started to use Memrise even before. The first 15 days or so, or 20 days I learned Korean, I used the Korean One, like the recommended course from Memrise itself, like Korean One. And that was not that good, I have to say. But here, when I'm only using this How to Study Korean course on Memrise, that's only the vocabulary. But if you use the normal Korean One course on Memrise, you have a lot of sentences, but you don't really understand how the sentences are built. You just learn them as a big block, and it's a bit weird, I have to say. I didn't like that. But now that I only use Memrise for only the vocabulary and not complete words or complete sentences, then it's a lot better, in my opinion. It's annoying as you do more decks. With deck you mean a course of unmemorize, or I'm not sure what you mean by deck. But this one is like a deck for you, right? A set of cards. Yeah, I mean, a set of cards can have subsets of cards, so I'm not sure which one you mean. But for example, this one is a course on Memrise, and this one is one level of that course. So not sure which one of you mean, but it doesn't matter, I guess. I was over 5k words when I stopped using it. For Japanese, you mean? 5k words? That's a lot. I think best way to study flashcards is Korean to English, or Korean to Korean. English to Korean might get annoying. I'm not sure, but in this course on Memrise here, you have like both directions. You have English to Korean and Korean to English. Here you learn. Yeah, here you see, okay, it's the English word here, and I have to put the Korean. But you also have the Korean at the top, and I have to select the English translation. So it's like both directions. I heard many people use Anki, and yeah, I might use Anki too in the future. But I will see. So far, I'm still fine. Maybe I'll switch in like a few weeks, maybe 1 or 2 months. I'm not sure. I will take a look at Anki for sure. Okay, to lock something. Yeah, I will use Memrise as long as I use howtostudykorean.com, because it really works well, because they created this deck with their grammar lessons in mind. So it really fits together. Yeah, but in the future, there's another nice website that also uses a lot of YouTube videos and so on, that is called Talk to Me in Korean. I will probably check that out soon as well. And with that, I will not use Memrise anymore, but something else. So maybe Anki, let's see. I'm not sure. But yeah, I will try out different things. But for now, the last like 40 days or so, I'm using this one, and it's nice. Okay, to lock something. This was this jam gyda. Was it this gyda?
Jamgyda.
Jamgyda. To teach. That was the long one. Gareuchida.
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 Dopda.
Dopda to help.
Dopda.
Look, for example, yes, you have Korean to English, so it's the other way. And also you have some listening sometimes, so it's not too bad, I say. Itta is to forget.
Itta.
Juda to give.
Juda.
Juda. Juda.
Juda.
Chitta to build.
Chitta.
Chitta. Okay. Gareuchida.
Gareuchida.
Gareuchida. Juda to give.
Juda.
Dopda. Dopda. Dopda.
Dopda. Ilhada.
Ilhada to work.
Ilhada.
Kajida. To own, to possess.
가지다.
가지다. To build, 갖다. 짓다. 짓다.
짓다.
Il is work, yes. I will show you something when I get to the word again. I will tell you something. Jam, that was to lock. Jamgyda.
잠그다.
To forget, jitta. Wait, what happened? Can you still hear me? Yes. I just had this sound that... I have no idea, to be honest. Like, Discord sound. You heard it as well. I think, was it Windows or was it Discord? Yeah, maybe it was Windows. Not sure what it was, but okay, you can still hear me, so it's fine. To forget itta.
Itta.
Itta. To be correct, matta.
Matta.
Matta. To own possess, kajida. Kajida.
Kajida.
Okay, so now, so here you have to work. Many verbs in Korean have this hada. So this. Ah, okay, it's selected. So this hada, in this case, il hada. The hada is for like at least like 60 or 70% of all verbs is to do, yes, right. So it's like il is work and il hada is to do work. So to work. And yeah, there are many different words like that. So that's you have very easy with Japanese and Turkish, very nice. So for example, marhada, marhada. This is the word marhada, and mal. This one is speech. Okay, this is speech. So marhada is to speak. Because you do speech, you speak. Yeah, so that's very often in Korean. Korean has some words from Chinese, and when they have Chinese origin, the verb, then it has this hada. But some other verbs don't have it, but very often they do. Very many have this Chinese origin, and then it's always noun plus hada means basically to do this noun. Okay, to give chuda. Chuda.
Chuda.
Chatta. To look for. To search for, to find. Okay.
Chatta.
To forget. Itta.
Itta.
Itta. To build. G with this one, right?
짓다.
Yeah, 짓다. Gadget. Not sure what you mean, gadget. Yeah, Inspector Gadget from that Menotic. Yeah, you're right, gadget. But I'm not sure which one it was, to be honest. Gadget, because I don't remember words that sounds like gadget, because yeah, sometimes these memes or the menotics on this website, they don't really make sense in my opinion. So sometimes I just click okay next, and I don't even like store the menotic in my head. I just learn it like this. Yeah, I would call myself pretty fluent in English, so I think that's not a problem. But still, sometimes the thing is, the problem is sometimes the people creating this menotics, they try to somehow map the Korean sounds to some existing English sentence, and sometimes that there is just no English word. I didn't want to say sentence, the English word. Sometimes there is just no English word that matches the sounds of the Korean word. So sometimes it's just stupid. Okay, yeah, but some words like have a very similar German word. So that's, then I use that one. For example, fur is toll, and toll is a German word for like great. Okay, to work, so we have il and then hada.
Ilhada.
Ilhada.
Matta.
Matta, to be correct.
Matta.
To search for chatta. Chatta.
Chatta.
Chatta. To be correct, matta.
Matta.
To own process, gajida. Ah, this one is the gadget, right? Gajida. I will not finish it, but I think this one is the inspector gadget. Gajida. But yeah, it just doesn't fit. Gajida. Gajida. I can put a space. If I remove the space, it will instantly accept it and go to the next one. So I want to have this here. So the space is obviously not here, but this is a word. Kajida. Kajida. And it makes no sense, you know? It's not even similar to gadget, in my opinion. Kajida. There's no D. And it's like a K because it's in the beginning, so it's not a G. So it's so weird. Kajida. Kajida.
Kajida.
This one is a good. This one had a good menotic. This one is like jamming the door. Like jam. So this one is really jam. Gida. Jam gida. Jam gida. Jam gida. Jam that door. Jam gida.
Jam gida.
To give, chuda.
Chuda.
Chuda. To help, topda. Topda. Topda.
Topda.
Topda. To search for, chatta. Ah, see, this is the correct pronunciation of the word, chatta, chatta, but it's the different ending consonant. Yes, da is dictionary form. Yes, they always end with da. Always, 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 always. Sometimes with hada and sometimes only with da, but always da. Da is the dictionary ending. Yes, dictionary form.
찾다.
찾다. 맞 맞다.
맞다.
잠그다.
잠그다.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm at 318 from only from this website. I did some before on another course on Memrise. I had like 100 there, so I'm at like 400 or so. Not sure. Ah, okay. Yeah, the big problem that you will face if you keep learning is if you go to lesson 6 here that I just did last week, you have a lot of different conjugations. So for example, this word here is mokta, this is to eat. Okay, to eat, mokta. And you have, like, of course, different conjugations for past, present, and perfect tense, future tense. But you also have, just for present, let's say, present tense, you have four different forms depending on the respect you need to show to the person you're talking to. So this is high respect, low respect form. Okay, it's the same for Japanese, yeah. Okay, so then you already know that. You have some in Turkish too. Okay, then it really sounds like it should all be a bit easier for you. You have a lot of the same things from Japanese and Turkish. That's good. So you can learn pretty nice. And this one is the plain form. This is like dictionary form. It's also used in like printing press, like newspapers and so on. It's also used there. Well, I don't think I will learn Japanese because my main focus was learning Korean. I'm not like a person who wants to know as many languages as possible. I just want to, like, the big goal is learning Korean itself, because my other hobby is StarCraft. That has the video game StarCraft. It has a very big Korean scene, and I want to understand all the Koreans and the Korean YouTube videos and so on for that other hobby. So that's the main goal, learning Korean. I don't want to learn as many languages as possible, so I don't think I will learn more after Korean, but let's see, maybe I will. And I really want to be fluent in Korean. I don't want to just barely get the meaning of some Korean sentences. No, I really want to learn it completely. Like, I want to be really good at it. I want to speak it, understand it, write it, everything very well, a very high level. So I will not stop with Korean for quite some time. I will learn Korean for a long time. So at least like probably 2 years or so. I don't know. Yeah, nice. I'm not a fan of K-pop. Like, I don't care about that music, but yeah, I play Brood War or StarCraft very often, like very often. So that's why that's my main motivation for this. By the way, I will show you something. One second. So here I put the YouTube link in my chat. I just want to show you very quickly my YouTube channel, because where is it? God damn it, here. It's wrong. One second. There we go. Now you should see it. Yes. Okay, so this is my YouTube channel. Like, I have a lot of StarCraft content here, but I also have playlists, and here in this playlist I have this Learning Korean with Ray playlist. This one. So if you go to the playlist here, you can see this project that I'm doing here, Learning Korean with Ray, like for every single day of my learning. And what I would just want to say is the first day, the very first day when I started, you can see like every video is about 1 hour long. It's always about 1 hour. But this first one is 2 hours. The first one, that's where I talk in the beginning. I talk about why I do this, what is my motivation, what past experience I have with languages before, how do I want to do this, what's my plan, stuff like that. So here I talk about this introduction. And then I start, and that's what I do every day. So every day at 6 p.m. So yeah, if you tune in again, if you want to check it out again, I'm doing it, as I said, every day 6 p.m. Yeah, but thanks a lot for your for watching and for your activity here in the chat. I appreciate it. It's always good to speak with other people and talk about experiences and so on. It sucks for Brutwa that there are no foreign teaching videos. I also want to learn Korean so I could watch people like Storik and learn what... Yeah, exactly. That's one of my motivations as well. But I'm not sure how much you checked or how long it was ago, but nowadays there's actually there are pretty nice things for new players. Since StarCraft Remastered was released, this remake, the remaster version of StarCraft, since then a lot of nice ways to improve as a beginner have emerged. So yeah, I don't know if you are interested in getting into StarCraft or improving in StarCraft and so on, getting a bit better. You can message me. I can show you a lot of stuff. Yeah, Jinjin channel is there as well. Yeah. Yes, that's true. I know that channel. But there's a whole league called the CPL that has CPL stands for Coach Pupil League, and it has coaches that are only there to coach newer players or lower skilled players and help them improve and show them what they should do to improve the fastest and so on. So yeah. Ah, okay. So so you're 1.8k. That's not that bad. So you're not really a beginner. But yeah. Anyways, I'm already at overtime. My girlfriend is waiting. This lesson is 1 hour and 30 minutes long already. Usually I always do 1 hour. So I really need to leave now. My girlfriend will be angry. So yeah, thanks again for watching. And yes, maybe we'll see each other again. So bye bye. Annyeong.